after cardio, you think, what's next? What's the next long run that we can have, or how do we train in the movie towers? Because movie towers are our second home,
base camp.
So from there we started the plan, but eventually the plan was to run in 2020. Shiv was the main culprit in this. So he said that, okay, Shiv and Shubham said, why 2020? Why not 2019?
And we said, यार कर दाते हैं छोड़ो अगले साल कौन देखा
कौन जिंदा है इस ईयर ओनली
सो द ट्रेनिंग प्लान इनिशियली व्हेन वी गेव द नंबर्स एवरीबॉडी वाज इट वाज माइंड बॉगलिंग सेइंग दैट ओके वी हैव टू रन 1500 किलोमीटर सो इट्स लाइक समबडी सेड अपना गाड़ी का माइलेज आज तक 1500 नहीं हुआ सो दैट वाज द फर्स्ट स्टिंकरिंग थिंग दैट कम्स टू मी Me, but we followed the Comrades official plan, and we pretty much aligned with Diganta and Amit because they had done it, so they knew how to crack. It's like how you accept or gate your exams. After Kadungla, one thing that we learned was we need to walk during our training plan, and we need to do Saturday Sunday. So that was by and large that we followed.
So as part of training also, you know, people normally go to Uti for the ultra run, to run that Uti 60K and all.
We did
as a training run, and we really did very well out there.
And also Srisailam.
So typically training for comrades like ultras is, you cover a mileage of roughly 300 kilometers a month. And do every month you should be doing one long run, which has good elevation, one long run as in 50 kilometers plus.
But I think we did more than that, at least some of us did 400 kilometers and all a month.
Some of us.
One or two, probably Diganta also.
Who were restless all the time and kept on running like a machine until the race start.
You know, they say meet up at 5 o'clock, but he and Diganta were coming to Mubu Tower at 4:30. So they always ditched.
But some of the training runs are really amazing, wherein we started the previous day, 10:30 PM we started, and we ran till next day 6 AM. So throughout the Hyderabad, one side of the Hyderabad to the other side we covered.
Yeah, all had our own, you know, training plans, right? While we were all running together on weekends, but individually we were doing our own thing a little bit. I was doing a little bit of cycling. I think you guys were doing a lot of strength training separately.
But on the serious note, it really took a lot from us, and we really trained very hard. Every Saturday, 35K, 38K.
And back to back, 40-50 kilometers was really. At some point, I felt like, why are we doing this? Because it's like you could feel it.
Did you really feel that?
Nutrition is a very important aspect whether you are training for half marathon, say full marathon, or a comrades training. So I just followed some basic nutrition plans of making just increasing the intake of protein while the mileage was going up.
Also goes, you know, it differs person to person what they like to follow. People like me, I believe in healthy eating. I don't eat outside. While I was in training, I was having a proper protein intake and good food at home. I have avoided.
So,
my
fund
is eat good and run well.
For me, I upped the protein intake quite drastically, and even eating a lot of nuts, cashew, almonds, pecans.
So, one thing that I looked at was throughout this period was like I had a lot of red meat. So, I used to concentrate on a lot of red meat, so that that builds a fat for me. So that's the only thing that I changed in my diet. So, rest was like as usual.
So a lot of goats around here.
Went missing.
Went missing. Missing. I know.
And how about you, Rajesh Dada? You had that Kepla. What do you had?
I think during the training, just focus on routine and avoid any sugar. Just cut down the sugar.
So for me, actually, this is different because last year, because of the weight issues, I suffered because you have to carry your own weight for 12 hours. So I wanted to shed few kgs. So for that, so my protein intake definitely I increased. But I started skipping my dinners, and not skipping, I replaced them with the salads and most of like mushrooms or soya. I replaced it with that. So that definitely helped a bit. I was able to manage few.
think family played a very important role in this whole race, because 6 months not going for a Sunday and a Saturday or a Saturday.
You're gone every weekend, right? Every weekend, 3 days in a week.
Family support, this event is not possible. We cannot sign up.
So it's a very wonderful experience for me, and I feel that every runner should run a Comrades Marathon in their life to experience what I had experienced. While there are ups and downs throughout the race, and it's a we go through different thoughts and pains, but at the end, the glory of finishing the race is like just amazing, and I literally had tears when I crossed the finish line. At some points, I literally stopped side of the road, and I was looking at the people, like sea of runners, just running.
Seriously,
the crowd support, the people cheering, and the Indian flag, and come on India, come on Rajesh. I mean, unbelievable. I mean, one has to run a comrade experience. I mean, we can't share over it, or I can't express this thing also. There is complete crowd support
both sides.
Right?
You know,
people are making barbecues with the car, the music on, the kids playing.
Dream. And the Brian Adams, you heard the Summer of 69 songs and everything.
This guy, Barry, who was the Comrades legend, was a 46 medal finisher, right? So at around 70 kilometer mark, I think we were slowly, lumbering along, and then suddenly he overtakes us. Okay, I said, "Hey, Barry, we go and take pictures with him," and he's going ahead in front of us. And Shubham says, "Srini Anna, uske medal jitne umar nahi hai hamari, wo hamari aage finish karega kya?" uske aage finish karenge. Then we actually overtook him. You finished 3 minutes ahead of him.
Initially, I took up like very fast, and
that you always do,
I started getting cramps. So I thought the first thing that came into my mind was, "Arey, if I chhod diya, toh mera dead lag chala gaya." Or that was the first thing that struck me, saying that okay, pura paisa gaya. Then okay, I linger on, move on till 10 kilometers, and meet a good physiotherapist over there. Throughout the race, that was the best part. So they ensured that they strapped the whole thing, both my calves, and from there I took off and I didn't stop. But
so when I saw people just doing the massage, just praying, I was just tempted to do that. But again, the second thought came, if I open the shoe, the bomb will burst.
I think the amount of chants I would have done, the whole 90 kilometers, Gayatri mantra, I don't think so throughout my life.
So I first half, basically my run was very nice. I was running a bit fast than my planned time. But after that, there was one downhill after that Inchanga, that 50% mark. And that downhill, my knee again started giving me trouble. The worst part is, can say worst part, because then you see those bailer buses, you see runners, retired runners sitting in that bailer buses, and you are so tempted that okay, your knee is not giving up, I don't know, you are just halfway done, and you
those bailer buses are very tempting.
Those are very tempting.
I think the one good thing, the comrades mile markings, it doesn't show the distance you have covered.
Right.
It shows the distance.
The remaining
countdown.
So psychologically, I think it helps.
So in Comrades, there is a Zulu saying which in English translates to "success is not guaranteed."